Need for emitter bypass capacitor. We know that this is a self-biasing circuit, and we know that this is a self-biasing circuit, and in this we have seen that different element is nothing but I. We hadn't seen this element in voltage in collector to base biasing circuit or in the fixed biasing circuit. We have seen this in the self-biasing or voltage divider biasing circuit. This is because we have seen that this RE has a negative impact on the forward biasing potential at the base emitter junction. This RE will drop more voltage at this position. If it is like that, if it is continuous with the AC signal, then it will adds up a negative feedback at the input side. This will brings down the output gain, that is the gain of the output signal, to a very mere value, that is very less value. If it is like that, then we will not get very faithful gain at the output. So we know that the capacitor is a good blockage for DC voltages, and it is a good conductor for AC signals. So if we include capacitor across the emitter resistor, then we will get a low resistance path for the AC signals, and we can continue the biasing potential which is required to keep the Q point stable. Likewise, this bypass capacitor is very useful in maintaining the Q point stable and getting good amplified signal at the output. Like that, this in the voltage divider circuit, bypassing capacitor is very useful. This is all about bypassing capacitor requirement in a voltage divider bias circuit.